Mountain Dog. And now the Bouvier de Flandre. Next we have the Boxer. The Bull Mastiff. The Eskimo Dog. The Giant Schnauzer. The Hovervort. The Leonberger. The Mastiff. And now the Neapolitan Mastiff. The Newfoundland. The Pinscher. The Portuguese Water Dog. The Rottweiler. And the St. Bernard. The Siberian Husky. The Tibetan Mastiff. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Doberman. And now for commentary on the individual breeds, I would like to hand you over to my colleague, Bernard Ball. Bernard.
They were judged today by Mrs. Ferrell Summerfield, and she had 75 dogs entered under her. The number of this one is 4929, and it is a dog. It's a breed raised and exhibited in much of North America and Europe. It's a popular dog for home sledding, and many owners of Malamute themselves also compete in weight pulling contests. And many of these dogs can shift up to a one ton load over a short distance. Very powerful dogs. The Alaska Malamute. Now we have the Bernese Mountain Dog, general farm dog from Switzerland. They were judged in the breed today by Mrs. Anne Latimer. She had a very good entry of 252 dogs. The number of this one, which actually is a bitch, is 5063. This dog carries the classic Swiss colouring of black and tan with white markings. It's a breed which can be traced back to the Roman invasion of what we now know as Switzerland some 2,000 years ago. Bernese Mountain Dog. Next on is the Bouvier de Flandre. There are 54 of chose this one, which is a dog. It's number 5306. Bouvier means bovine or cattle herder. And each region throughout Belgium and France has its own type. The dogs will stand up to 68 centimetres, which is 27 inches if you're with us. The bitches up to 65, which is 25 and a half. Dogs can weigh up to 88 pounds or 40 kilograms, and the bitches 77 pounds, 35 kilograms. Now we have the boxer, strongly built, muscular dog, which comes to us originally from Germany. There were 316 of these entered today, and the judge was Mr. Karjavina. He chose this one, which is a dog, 5518. Behind the boxer are believed to be breeds such as the Great Dane and the Bulldog. Boxer is a refined version of the old bull-biting dog, the Bullenbeißer. Dogs stand up to 25 inches at 63 centimetres, and bitches 23 inches, which is 59 centimetres. After the boxer, we have the Bull Mastiff. The breed was judged by Mr. R.G. Snell, with a good entry of 199. He chose the dog 5796. Powerful British dog, has a square skull and muzzle, stands up to 27 inches in the dog, just over 68 centimeters. And they can weigh up to 130 pounds. They become brindle, fawn, or red with a black muzzle. Bull Mastiff is today a show dog, though of course originally it was called the gamekeeper's night dog and would be set against poachers. Now we have the Doberman. We had two judges today, Mr. John McManus and Mrs. Hilary Partridge Dutton. Mr. McManus had 141 dogs, and the lady judge had 146 bitches, and the eventual choice was the dog 7140. Quite a distinctive breed, alert, old, and tough, bred originally for a specific purpose, and that was aiding a tax collector called Herr Louis Doberman in his duties. Dobermans are capable of a variety of disciplines, from guarding to guide dog work for the blind, and also to act as police dogs. Dogs stand up to about 27 inches at the withers, the bitches 25 and a half. Next we have the Eskimo dog. The appointed judge was Madame Janet Al-Haddad. She chose the dog 6116 from an entry of 9. These are tough freight hauling dogs, Arctic dog, with Canada as its home country, because it was Canada which fostered and saved the breed. The name indicates it's a dog used by the Eskimo race, serving as a sled hauler in winter and a backpacker in summer. It had the ability to hunt seals and bears all the year round. Giant Schnauzer, one of the three varieties of Schnauzer and the only one in the working group, judged was Mr. Sid Saddle. he had an entry of 17, and his was the dog 6138. The breed is almost square in shape, and the giant should be a robust animal. It comes in black or salt and pepper, with shades ranging through dark iron grey to light grey. Stands 27.5 inches in the dog, which is 70 centimetres, slightly shorter in the bitch. In Germany, the home country, the breed is still used for security work, and it has given service as both a police and a war dog. Moving on now to the Great Dane, which is actually the national dog of Germany and has been so since 1876. The number of this one is 6298. It is a dog. It comes from an entry of, oh sorry, it's a bitch, I corrected. It comes through from an entry of 237. And the judge was Mr. Jeff Burton. Here we have a breed which is required by the Kennel Club standard to have a dog which is over 18 months, weighing in at 120 pounds, that's 54 kilograms, and a bitch at 100 pounds. Come in a variety of colours, brindle, fawn, blue, black or hardwood. Actual hide colour, black or blue on white. Now we have the Omafart, judged by Mr. Terry Munro, general farm dog from Germany. 32 are entered today, and this is the dog 6442. It has a history which goes back to the 1200s, but there came a blank space in their history for many years. There was no mention of them in formal dog circles. Then it reappeared at the turn of the 1900s, and it's come on to be recognised now as one of our show dogs. Dogs will stand up to 27.5 inches, that's 70 centimetres, bitches a couple of inches or 5 centimetres shorter. Here we have the Leonberger, a large, strong, muscular dog which comes to us from Germany, a breed which was especially created. And he was judged today by Mr. Peter Radley, who chose this one, which actually is a bitch, 6491, for an entry of 118. Mayor of Leonberg, certain Heinrich Essig, who created the breed to honor his town. He tried to produce a dog which he thought would have some similarity to a lion, hence the Leon part of the name. We move on from the Leonberg to the Neapolitan Mastiff. The judge was Mr. Christopher Pavic, who comes to us from abroad to judge 26 of this breed, and he chose as his best of breed the dog 6662. As you can see, here we have a powerful dog, and a dog with a long history. Our thoughts, his ancestry may well go back to the ancient Tibetan Mastiff. Italy's native dog. We see history for the Neapolitans are direct descendants of the masses of the Roman fighting arenas. Dr. Ronald James, judge the Mastiffs. This one is 6652. It's a dog, came through for an entry of 79. Dogs usually stand around 30 inches, that's 76 centimeters, making it a pretty hefty dog. Bitches stand a little less than that. Mastiffs were here when the Romans came to invade Britain, and they were so impressed that they took Mastiffs back to Rome to fight in the arenas. Country of origin is given as Britain. Newfoundland is next. A dog built for strength and has an oily, water repellent coat, and it has also webbed feet. Judged today was Mrs. Margaret Everton. She chose this dog 6732 for an entry of 232. These dogs can stand up to 28 inches and 71 centimeters. The bitch is a couple of inches shorter. It's a breed which in this country has regular water tests. These water tests mark back to the origins of the breed working with the fishing boats of Newfoundland. It's a breed which also can be seen sometimes pulling carts. Back to Germany now for this breed, the pincher. The judge was Dr. Monica Lodger Back. Of 22 and chose this dog 6926. Pincher is the German word for terrier, but the German farmer's terrier is larger than its English counterpart. It is also an alert guard dog used for home protection and also to control vermin. Officially recognized by the German Kennel Club in 1879. Type was set around the turn of the century. The Portuguese water dog, judged by Mr. John Burroughs today. There's an entry of 31, and this one is best of breed 6956, is a dog. Portuguese water dogs are in fact great water dogs, and their entire hindquarters are clipped to facilitate their working characteristics. Comes obviously from Portugal. It's a breed which has been associated with the fishermen of that country, but actually stems from the same rootstock as the other water dogs of Europe. Believed to have arrived in what is now its homeland by importation there by dog traders. The Boers came by way of North Africa. Moving on now to the Rottweiler. This one is 7140. It is a dog. It came from an entry of 138 dogs and 163 bitches, which were judged today by Mr. Michael Hammond, he did the dogs, and Mr. Bill Burrows, who judged the bitches. Not really agreed for those who allow their dogs to rule them, but the Rottweiler, if trained properly, makes him intelligent, fearless, and a loyal companion. And we have our next breed, which has been romanticized about St. Bernard. judge was Mr. Joe Kirk. This one is a dog, 7306, chosen from an entry of 113. It's a breed which has been immortalized in legend and in painting. It's probably known to everybody, even if they know very little about dogs. One of the breed went to Best in Show at Thrush some years ago. These dogs are associated with the rescues of the deep snows of the Swiss Alps. Painted by Edwin, later Sir Edwin Landseer, when he was only 17. Now we have the Siberian Husky. It's the Malamute and the Eskimo dogs and the cart horses. The Siberian is the racehorse of the Arctic. And this breed today was judged by Mr. John Carter. He chose the bitch 7491 from a good entry of 208. The country of registration of this breed is the United States. Its name actually comes, as you can tell, from Siberia. It's also sometimes called the Arctic Husky. It's a breed which we see in the showroom quite regularly. And it also works out on the trails during the winter months, particularly hauling sleds if we have snow, or wheel rigs when the snow is scarce, and they can cover ground at a pretty good speed. Tibetan Mastiff. A second breed today for Dr. Monica Hodgio-Black. There's an entry here of 22, and she chose this one, which is the dog 7599. Tibetan Mastiff comes from time to time, and it comes up from time to time in certain breed histories. Many think this may be the missing link between the flock guarding dogs and the Mastiff breeds, being associated even with the Newfoundland. Tibet has traveled widely without its arm and break, sowed the seed for so many of today's Mastiffs and flock guarding breeds. Tibetan Mastiff. That, ladies and gentlemen, is the last of our dogs in the working group, which now contains 20 breeds. Mr. Thorne is going to go from these 20 now to a short list of 6. Chosen one of the 6 that Mr. Thorne is going to pull out. After we have the new founder, we have the Mastiff. Thank you all. Cheer on your favourite, that's right. The Bouguet 5306. The Bull Mastiff, 5796. The Doberman, 5902. Now we have the Mastiff, 6652. Finally, the new Falcon, 6732. Here come the stewards with the four group placing pedestals. As they take their places, we're going to ask Mr. Andrew Thompson to come out and present the trophies, and he will be escorted by Mr. Ed Simpson. Please welcome your presenter, Mr. Thompson. Oh, I'm sorry, I can kick the door and I do beg your pardon a little bit. And now it's the Bouguet. Then it's the boxer, and in the fourth position we have the founder. And Mr. Thorne is congratulating the other two, the Mastiff and the Bull Mastiff. Well done to all of them. I'm sorry I got ahead of myself. Now, ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome Mr. Andrew Thompson, escorted out by Mr. Ed Simpson. There they go. A big hand for Mr. Thompson, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations to the Doberman, 5922. Second place, the Bouguer, 5306. Oh my goodness me, get out! Can we send security guards, please? Ladies and gentlemen, sorry for the distraction. Can you please give your presenter and your judge a very big thank you? Thank you, Mr. Vaughan. And now, ladies and gentlemen, continue your clapping as the dogs go down and get off by the road.